What's going on, Rushers? Welcome back to Stage Rush TV. If you've turned on your TV anytime soon, you probably realize, like I have, that there's a lot of new Broadway commercials that are hitting the channels right now. There are so many new Broadway shows that are coming in the spring, and here we are to give a spring preview of some of the shows that I'm most excited about. Well, here we are at the Palace Theater, where Priscilla, Queen of the Desert, is coming soon. The show is about a bunch of drag queens that tour on this big, shiny LED bus, and it stars Will Swenson and Nick Adams. I don't know if the show is something that's really my speed, but I predict that this show is going to be a really, really big fan favorite, and it starts previews on February 28th. Here we are at the Barrymore Theater, where Arcadia will be starting performances on February 26th. Now, the reason I want to see this show, two words. Raul Esparza. I'll see anything that he's in. He's back, coming back to Broadway before he does Leap of Faith, whatever that's going to be, and I'm so excited to see him. This is a Tom Stoppard play. A lot of people I know really like this play, but Tom Stoppard and his usual work and the way that this play sounds to me, it's going to be very dense, so I'm sure that I'm going to be in the audience scratching my head the whole time, but at least I'll be watching Raul Esparza, so it'll be fantastic. How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying is coming to the Al Hirschfeld Theater, beginning previews on February 26th. This is the one that's got Daniel Radcliffe in it. He's coming off his first Broadway play, which was Equus, which was fantastic. And it's a musical. He's doing his first musical, so it's incredibly exciting. I can't wait to see how he sings, what the quality of his voice is like. Everyone can't wait. But what also is cool about this is that this is How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying. He won the Pulitzer Prize way back when for drama, and so it's really exciting to see another Pulitzer Prize winning musical, of which there are only six. And this is also director choreographer Rob Ashford's follow-up to the very successful Promises from last season. Well, here at the Eugene O'Neill Theater, which is one of my favorite theaters on Broadway, this is where the revival of Sweeney Todd and Spring Awakening played, and so I'm so excited to come here to see a new musical, and this is Book of Mormon coming here. Now, this is the one that was written by Trey Parker and Matt Stone, the creators of South Park, and the buzz is that it's going to offend everybody and it's going to be raucous, and it's also from the writer of Avenue Q, which is fantastic. So you know you're in for a good time. Now the thing is, I've also been hearing that Book of Mormon is going to be extremely clever, extremely smart, and that this is going to be the musical to beat come Tony's, so this is really exciting, so I'm very excited to see this show and how it turns out. Catch Me If You Can is coming to the Neil Simon Theater, beginning previews on March 11th. This is such a great cast. This is Aaron Tveit, Norbert Leo Butz, and Cary Butler. So you got three of pretty much the best actors, especially the most like up-and-coming modern actors on Broadway. And you know, this to me seems like it's going to be a very big crowd pleaser like Memphis was last season. And this seems to be like a very dance-heavy, traditional Broadway musical, so I think it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm really excited to see how it goes. But what I'm most excited to see is actually Aaron Tveit coming off of Next to Normal in a supporting role, taking on the leading man and carrying a show all by himself. So what about you, Rushers? I want to know what Broadway show you are most excited for coming along in the spring. Let me know in the comments below. Moving on to some Broadway grosses, Good People started off its previews with a really strong start with 91% of its tickets. Lombardi actually climbed back up quite a bit, selling 81% of its tickets. Million Dollar Quartet climbing up a little bit, still staying at the same place it's always been, almost breaking the 70% range, selling just under at 69%. And that championship season is also starting off with a very strong preview period, selling 89% of its tickets. That's all for this week. Have a great week at the theater.